Do you install your receptacles and your switches before drywall or after? All right, so this was a good question brought by Chase Mitchell on the episode 3, how to wire and install a switch video. The best way to do it, you gotta think about like the process of a job. If you were to put devices in before drywall, them trying to actually put drywall over the device is gonna be really hard. A lot of times they take a rotozip and they cut around the box, and if you already have a device in there, the little tabs from the device on the bottom and top are gonna get messed up, or they'll go and stick the rotozip in and actually like mess up the receptacle. So it's way harder on the whole process. And it ends up damaging. I mean, you gotta think of like, if a house has like 100 receptacles and like 60 switches, you know, they're gonna mess up so many different things that I don't do that beforehand. I always do it after. So we have a rough-in stage, and the rough-in is where you put boxes and wire only, everywhere, for, you know, lights, for recessed cans, everything. And then we do our trim out. Some people call it like a make ready or finish out stage. We just call it trim out. You put all the can trims in, you put all the devices and plates and everything on. When you go and put the devices in and you put the plates, you're bringing all of these trim out materials together during one phase. So in the rough in, you bring all the wire, you bring all the boxes and get everything prepped and wired. You do the rough in stuff, so you have a certain kind of material that you're bringing in, and it's stuff that can get banged up because it doesn't really matter. It's all just going in walls. But on the trim out phase, you bring all of your receptacles, your plates, your switches, your can trims. The builder is gonna have probably all of the ceiling fans and light fixtures. You really only have to be there for two different phases of a job. And when you do the trim out, it's everything's like kind of like fine, neat finish work. I always wait till after paint and texture, because I don't want to put all of my devices in on walls and they're sitting there spraying texture all over, because they're going to spray like half of your switches. And then you'll have all of these decor, you know, paddle switches that won't actually move because they're like glued together with spackle. Same thing with paint. They're gonna overpaint, you know, they're gonna get your devices all crappy. You could in theory go and like tape every single one of the devices off, but then honestly people in the receptacles are gonna take their extension cords and they're gonna come in and they're gonna start trying to plug into receptacles because they see them there and they think that there's gonna be power, and then all of that tape's gonna get like gunked on the inside. Things are just gonna get damaged. So I always, always, always do it at the end, after paint and texture. Usually the cabinets are already put in as well, probably not countertops. In most cases, I always try to have us come out before they put countertops on. And the reason for that is a lot of times in cabinets or in islands, we'll actually need to get in and like run some Carflex or run some wire, try to get some receptacles cut into those islands. And it's much harder to do all of that when you don't have access to get inside of the cabinet. We do massive custom homes. So I always, always, always tell them, don't have me come in and just like put one plug here and one plug over here and then 3 weeks later be like, hang this one light, you know? It's like, no. Once the paint dries and you've got all your cabinets set, so there's not just like wires sticking out of the ground, you know, coming up from the slab, have us come out. We'll do the entire trim out from beginning to end. And then when that's all done, by that time, most of the other trades have gotten all of their, you know, toilets and bathtubs and showers and everything in. So then we can call for power and we can build our service on the outside of the house. We can put the meter can in. Sometimes we have like a gutter and CTs, like a CT can enclosure, service panels, all of that. We can get that whole thing built, get it inspected, and then have the power company come out and actually stab a meter in place. And then we can turn on all of the receptacles and put all the breakers in, get all the switches hot, test all the lighting and everything like that. But we kind of do that as one big phase that we call trim out. Anyways, long explanation for probably a very simple answer. But I hope you got some value out of that. If you want to see a little bit about the different phases of construction, I've got a video here that I talk about pretty much from the ground up how a building or how a home should be built. If you want to see like how I actually wire for receptacles and switches and stuff like that, click this video here and I walk you through my whole process of how I prep in the rough-in stage before we get to trim out. And as always, I love you crazy people and I'll see you in the next episode.